कृष्णा कृष्णा।
What a dance it was! Shri Krishna on the many hoods or heads of Kalia, that Kalia who was holding inside him such yucky poison. Not only was he bitter and angry, he was hurting many because he was afraid of Garuda, who was always there to check this poisonous, angry Kalia. However, when Krishna danced on Kalia, every time he raised a hood to strike, Krishna pressed his leg on his hood and made him vomit out his poison. And like that, Krishna danced from one hood to another hood to another hood. And that way, Kalia's heads were all now without poison. When the poison was out of Kalia, and the wives and children of Kalia prayed to Krishna, Krishna smiled and Kalia asked for forgiveness but admitted that he was very afraid of Garuda. That's why he was living in this place where Garuda could not come. But Krishna said, this is place for everyone to drink pure water. You go to the ocean. But when Krishna was dancing on Kalia, all the gopas and the gopis, all the cowherd men and women, watching Krishna dance on Kalia's head, made Krishna dance in their mind. Do you know, our mind also is made up of many, many thoughts, like the many heads of Kalia. But when we fill in it poison, anger, bitterness, then not only we remain alone and nobody likes us, so we get even more angry. At the same time, in that anger, in that feeling frustrated, they do harmful things to others. If we make Krishna dance in our mind, he will make us throw out all our anger, all our poison of our minds, all the yucky thoughts. He will throw it out. He will smash that yucky thought. And when Krishna dances in your mind, and how will you make Krishna dance in your mind? Gopal, Gopal, nacho, Gopala, nacho, nacho, mere Nandlala, nacho, nacho, mere Nandlala, nacho, nacho, mere Nandlala. Keep singing. Gopala, 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 Krishna, 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 and Krishna will remove all those yucky thoughts from our mind and make us happy, cheerful, loving boys and girls, men and women, where we bring joy to everyone. In the same manner, after Krishna had told Kalia now to go and live peacefully in an island in the ocean, now that everybody were free of Kalia and the poison of Kalia and the river flowed so beautifully, everyone who had come there so anxious about Krishna's welfare. They were so tired. They slept there only and had a picnic at night there. And they all slept together on the sandy banks of the river Yamuna with Krishna in midst of them. But suddenly at night, because summer had already come in, there was a wild forest fire. Even though they were on the banks of the river, they could not escape from there, and the fire was burning everywhere. While they were sleeping, suddenly it became so hot, and when they woke up, there was fire everywhere. But by now, they knew that if Krishna is there, if Krishna is near, there is nothing to fear. They all called out to Krishna, "Krishna, Krishna, you have saved us from all difficulties, calamities, problems. Now there is a fire." And Krishna just went close to the forest and he just swallowed the fire. Everybody now knew that Krishna was no ordinary child. He swallowed the entire fire. And you know, fire also is there in our speech. We need our speech to be strong when we are saying good things and sweet when we are saying good things. But at the same time, we can also hurt people by speaking a fiery language, hurting language. Shri Krishna swallowed up the fire so that we do not hurt people with our speech. Otherwise, very often we burn the hearts of people with our speech by making them jealous sometimes, sometimes by saying hurting words. Sometimes we say even hurting words to our parents. We should try not to. At such time when you are feeling very angry, remember Krishna, Krishna, and he will swallow away all your angry words. So that even if you have to say something which is right and you want to correct, you can say it nicely. Krishna swallowed that fire. Everybody was saved and everybody said, "Bolo Krishna Kanhaiya Lal Ki Jai." Say loudly, "Shri Krishna Kanhaiya Lal Ki Jai." Now, even though the summer month has come, but Krishna with all the gopas would go to the forest. And they used to go now deeper, and now that they had grown up, deeper and deeper into the forest so the cows could get fresh grass. And while they went to the forest, exploring the forest, seeing the beautiful, beautiful, beautiful nature, they played many games. And what games do you play? They played many, many games in the forest. Not only, sometimes they used to dance. And you know what? They did every form of dance. Classical dance. They actually even did hip-hop, because they used to jump up and down and they used to make many twists. They used to do many somersaults. And sometimes Krishna and Balaram used to sing and all their friends used to sit and dance because they sang so beautifully. Sometimes they would sing and Krishna would dance, and sometimes flowers in his hair, sometimes even fruits and cherries hanging from his ears, and all the gopas would delight. And the gopis sitting at home used to think how lucky these gopas are. They spend the whole day with Krishna. What would Krishna be doing? What would Krishna be doing now? Sometimes they would want to just leave their homes and go to the forest and see Krishna play. But this privilege the gopas had. But the gopis in their hearts kept Krishna, and all the time in their inner mind, in their inner eyes, they would see Krishna play. Sometimes they played blindfold exercise. They would blindfold them and play those games. And you had to go and search. And people from behind will tap you. And you go turning around. And then they would go far away. Sometimes Krishna would be tapped. And Krishna would have to be blindfolded. And Krishna would be searching his friends. And they would take this opportunity. Somebody would come and touch his arm. And Krishna would go in that direction. They would run away. Somebody would come and touch his shoulder. And he would go in that direction. And that way every friend of theirs wanted to just touch Krishna. And then Krishna used to catch someone. And they would go blindfolded. And then Krishna would tease them. And they would play such lovely, lovely games. Sometimes, suddenly from behind, somebody would come and hold the eyes on Krishna. And others would say, guess who it is? And very often, Krishna could guess rightly. But sometimes he used to play, I don't know, give me some clues. Sometimes Krishna would go behind someone and close their eyes. And they had to guess who it was. Do you know? Krishna also wants to play these games with you. Would you like to play these games with Krishna? Sometimes they used to take hard fruits and make it like a ball and play with the ball. Sometimes they would slap their hands and they would wrestle with each other. All in fun and games. They used to play such lovely, lovely games. One day, one asura, one demon, and Kamsa had heard about what all this little boy of Vrindavan had done. He was always afraid. And all these terrible, terrible people wanted to come and see Krishna, see the power of Krishna, and not only defeat Krishna, but kill Krishna. And one of them was Pralamba. Pralamba means long. No? He came and he took the form of one of the cowherd boys. Now there were so many cowherd boys, but Krishna knew all his friends. He told Balram, look, that boy who has come to join us, he doesn't seem to be a cowherd boy. He's not a gopa. He doesn't know what to do. He could be a rakshasa, a demon, taking this form to not only harm us, but harm these children. So be alert. Be careful. Sometimes who comes amongst your friends and tries to play mischief, try to do wrong things, and make others do wrong things. And they were playing a game, and he suggested, let's play a game where we make two groups, and the person from the group that loses carries the person from the group which wins, and they wrestle with each other. This Pralamba first wanted to be in Krishna, in Balram's group, so that he could carry Krishna on his head and then take him far away. But even he had heard about Krishna, and even watching that Krishna, who looks so gentle with his soft, soft hands, but he could see the power of Krishna and he was afraid. He said, I don't want to fight with Krishna. So he said, let me first take this Balram. He did not know that Balram was also very powerful. But he knew by now that Krishna has defeated many, many asuras, many, many rakshasas, many, many demons, and all these terrible, terrible creatures. So he was afraid. And once while playing, he was able to carry Balram on his shoulder. And while everybody on the shoulder were trying to drop each other from the shoulders of others, he went outside the circle of the game and tried to run into the forest, catching Balram by his legs on his shoulders. Suddenly, Balram realized that this boy is taking me away from everybody, taking me away from Krishna. And first, Balram was a little afraid, but Balram reminded himself that he is Krishna's brother and he is mighty and powerful. Suddenly he became so powerful, he became so heavy that that Pralambasura who was running with him on his shoulders, holding Balram tight. When he first was running, he was running very fast, very fast, very fast, very fast. Slowly, he started becoming tired, 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 tired. And he couldn't move at all. And he came to a standstill. And Balram became heavier and heavier and heavier. He suddenly could not keep his boy form and turned into a huge, long, tall demon. And Balram was on his shoulder. Balram saw him as a demon and Balram started hitting his shoulders, hitting his head. Pralambasura started screaming and wanted to throw Balram out of his shoulder. But Balram was Krishna's brother. He gave him one smash and Pralambasura laid down there. All the boys, when they heard the screams of Pralambasura, they came running there and saw Balram standing there strong and Pralambasura on the ground. Krishna came and hugged Balram and said, Balram bhaiya, you are so strong. You protected us all. And all the boys came and hugged Krishna and Balram because they were there to save them all the time. Sometimes you don't even know these people. And also, inside us sometimes these asuras come also. Not only sometimes amongst our friends, but this was Pralambasura. That makes us sometimes when you have to study, not now, I'm not in the mood. We must study when it is time to study. We must work when it is time to work. We must play when it is time to play. But we should not keep on delaying. Otherwise, this Pralamba can carry us away, far away from what we want to achieve, from our goal. Take us far, far away. So, what you need to do, do it on time. So, now they again went back to play. And now the summer had increased. But because of Krishna being there, and where Krishna is there, nature is protected. And when nature is protected, nature protects us. Now when it is summer, the sun is bright and close to that hemisphere, northern hemisphere or southern hemisphere of the earth when there is summer. But all the trees, the rivers, cool up the place, and especially Yamuna River. As she flowed, she would throw up sprays of water, and the wind used to carry it, and it was so refreshing that even though it was middle of summer, yet the weather was so refreshing, because who was there? Krishna. But one day, when it was very, very dry, and when it is very dry, far into the forest, away from the river Yamuna, the cows and all the goats, the calves, were all brought by Krishna and the Gopas, were feeling very hot and thirsty. So in search of water, they went far away while these boys were playing. Suddenly Krishna realized that the cows were not there. In search of the cows, they went into the forest and they couldn't find the cows because they had gone far away in search of water. Krishna went searching, all the boys went off searching. And suddenly, in the forest, these things can happen. And therefore, we must be very, very careful that those of you who live near forest, where it is dry, see that you don't spark anything. These boys were very careful, but suddenly a forest fire again burst out. The animals were running here and there. The boys were surrounded by fire. But they know that Krishna was near, and if Krishna is near, there is nothing to fear. They immediately ran to Krishna and said, "Krishna, Krishna, please save us from this fire." And Krishna said, "All of you, don't be afraid. Just close your eyes. And whenever the gopas or the gopis, and I know all of you, when you close your eyes, you see Krishna." And they were seeing only Krishna, that they were not even afraid. And while they were seeing Krishna and they were calm, not afraid anymore, Krishna stood there, opened his mouth, and he swallowed the fire again. Fire also is there in our eyes as light to see. But what we see and what looks we give can set our life or even people and world on fire. Krishna took away that fire and kept it controlled inside him. Sometimes in nature, there is fire in the forest. It is sometimes to rejuvenate the forest. But we should see how we can protect all the creatures by not lighting up such forests, but letting nature take its course. And Krishna told the Gopa boys, "Now you can open your eyes." And they found that they were outside the forest, far away from the forest where there was the fire, and all the cows and calves were all safe. And they looked at Krishna and said, "When you are near, there is nothing to fear." And Krishna smiled at all of them. And looking at Krishna's smile, all the Gopa boys would forget what fear, what pain they had experienced. And when they came from the forest, all the gopis would be waiting on their windows sills. They would be waiting at the door, all looking out towards the forest to see Krishna along with the gopas, some of them their children only. with the cows and the goats and all the animals coming, and with the dust of their feet, the golden sands of Vrindavan, lit by the light of the sun, and most beautifully, shining like glitter on Krishna's dark body, like gold on Krishna's body, and Krishna's body radiant like the jewel. The gopis used to wait and see. And when Krishna came playing his flute, and the children playing their horns and their drums, the gopis used to find such great delight and would bless their eyes because they are there only to see this beautiful sight. And their hearts, that whole day while churning butter, were thinking about Krishna, 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 Krishna. When they saw Krishna, they would sometimes go running just to hug Krishna and feed him butter. And Krishna thrilled them with his side glances, with his look, his sweet words, and his loving laughter. So laugh, my children. Smile, your children. Then you can experience the laughter and smile of Krishna. Krishna, Krishna. Krishna, Krishna. Krishna, Krishna. Krishna, Krishna.